And your child is how old?
5.
Will you tell her about this?
I feel like eventually I'll have to. I don't even know how you do that. I don't even know how to address that with her or when the right time would be or any of that.
The time to answer her questions, the time to tell her what the truth is when she becomes inquisitive and really wants to know and ask the questions and ask the follow-up. Because if she asks the question and, you know, it's like, where's my daddy? Well, you know, we've got a divorce and he's just not in your life. Well, she won't ask follow-ups about that until many years from now.
Okay.
And when she does ask the follow-up, you need to be prepared to give an informed answer. Because you think about what her questions are going to be. Because he's that way, am I genetically predisposed to be that way?
Right.
Because he has that capacity, does that make me cold? Does that make me a killer? Does that make me a psychopath? Is that in me?
Right.
You have to know the facts to answer that question. You have to not only say, well, no, honey, of course not.
Right.
You have to say that there's not a genetic predisposition to that. So absolutely, unequivocally, no. This is something that happened as a function of his march through life. The fact that she has a father that is a confessed serial killer does not make her any more likely to do that than the neighbor kid.
Right.
And you absolutely should protect her from him until she is fully grown and mature. And ask the questions and the follow-ups.
Right.
And then say, now that you want to know, I'll answer it, but I'm going to give you a long answer to a short question. And that's when you tell her the full answer.
Right.